Jarrett maintain his focus and the U.S. championship belt with Uncensored just 11 days away. We'll have the answers to those questions over the course of the next 2 hours as the superstars of WCW and the NWO do battle on the Superstation TBS. You are looking at the Joel Coliseum. We are in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, at the home of the Wake Forest Demon Deacons. And if you want madness in the month of March, you've come to the right place. Mike Tenay, Bobby Heenan with you, and Brain, there's a fine line between champion and number one contender. Tonight on this program, three title bouts, the U.S. Championship, the World Tag Team titles, and we open up with the world's cruiserweight belt at stake. The artist, formerly known as Prince Iaukea, making his way to the ring accompanied by Paisley. And it was this past Monday on Nitro when we saw the interference by the Prince using the championship belt. It all broke loose, and then Psychosis and Hoovy turned their attention to the artist.
You're right about that, Mike. Tonight is action-packed. I don't know what's going to happen. No one knows what's going to happen. But I'll tell you something. With three championship matches on the card, everything's here. Everybody's ready. Watch what's going to go on.
There you see that Cruiserweight Championship belt. Artist used as a weapon this past Monday on Nitro. His opponent tonight on Thunder, well, it's a man who had advanced to the semifinals of the Cruiserweight tournament before visa problems cost him his shot at WCW gold. Well, tonight, Psychosis gets his chance against the champion, and wait a minute, Juventud Guerrera is with Psychosis.
Now, let's just get a look and see what's going on here.
Finally, the juice is locking down, baby! And he's back in town because there's millions and millions of Jesus fans all around the world. Today are waiting for me. They are waiting for La Vida Loca.
They were?
I think so.
So tonight, like you know, I'm gonna be the announcer, okay? So
wait a minute, no.
I'm gonna do
job,
man.
No, you're not scheduled.
Because the juice is in the house.
You're not scheduled to be here.
And that's with the juice, my bad.
What's wrong? Let him be here. He's good. He's a great announcer.
You're not scheduled to be the announcer.
I'm here because I wanna leave La Vida Loca. Who wants to leave La Vida Loca?
I guess he's just gonna do what he wants.
So, what's the problem? You got something better than the juice?
You know what? As a matter of fact, we do.
What? What do you got?
Listen to the music. Hey! What do you mean?
Hey! You know that music, don't you, Mike?
Yeah, and it's been a long time since we've seen Rey Mysterio Jr., and he's back. How's that?
Well, Hoovy, doesn't like it at all.
Psychosis, you can throw your temper tantrums all night, but Ray Ray's in the house. Speaking in my face. Yeah. Rey Mysterio Jr. is here to do color commentary, pal.
Mike, you're starting a lot of trouble here. Let them do what they want. I'd rather have Juventud here than Ray Jr.
Speak for yourself.
I am.
Well, you're outnumbered.
He's talking to you.
Excuse me. Rey Mysterio Jr. joins us here at the broadcast position, and Rey, there are a lot of people that are asking when you are going to return to the ring. The question that I have is, when you come back, can you come back to World Championship Wrestling after three very serious knee surgeries?
That's right, after three surgeries. But you know what? The faith is still in little Rey Rey. I'm coming back. Doc said 3 months. Let's hope it's sooner.
So you're saying about 3 months from now? Now, I know it's tough to project down the line, but where's your head as you prepare for your eventual return to World Championship Wrestling?
My head is totally focused. I'm coming back. starting the new generation like we used to have it. And you know what? This title is on the line right now. Do you know who the real owner of the title is?
Well, I know there are a lot of people that would consider you.
Yes.
But that's your championship that the artist is wearing. What a move that was by Psychosis.
That's right, props.
Off the top.
That's right, Tanae. You know what? I started building this competition with the Cruiserweight title, and I think I deserve a shot. My mind is still set.
And look at that, Juventud Guerrera.
That's another person that's gonna be in front of me.
Well, you know, those of us with a sense of history realize that Juventud and Paisley, in an animated conversation on the floor here, realize that Juventud Guerrera has been your arch rival throughout the years.
That's right, Juventud and Psychosis, both together. Oh!
Stiff kick delivered between the shoulder blades by the artist. But you have to admit, the artist, given the opportunity, went through the top cruiserweight, still active in WCW, winning the cruiserweight title tournament at Super Brawl.
Took over. It might have been luck. You know, whatever it was, he's the owner right now. But like I said, Tanae, I got my mind set. 3 or 4 months, maybe it's sooner. And the first thing I'm going to do is when I come back, I'm going to be looking for that belt.
You know, Ray, let me explain something to you. The rumor is out that you're Goldberg and you're laying on the shelf not doing nothing, that you're not really hurt as bad as you think. You're afraid of a lot of the competition. That's just the rumor I hear.
That's right. Yeah, I do lay off Saturday and Sundays. But I'm throughout, you know me, party hog, party animal, Saturday and Sunday, all the time. Monday and Friday, deep, intense workout.
Psychosis applies the abdominal stretch. WCW Cruiserweight title on the line. The champion, the artist formerly known as Prince Iaukea, has been on the defensive much of this matchup. But wait a minute, referee Charles Robinson down.
Knockout.
He got in the way. I tell you, I like the Prince. I tell you why. He's taken it to a new level. He realizes what he has to do, whether he uses his thumb, whether he uses his foot, no matter what he does. I don't know if it was intentional or not what he did, but I couldn't tell.
What about Paisley?
How about Paisley at ringside as well?
She's hot.
The float over by Psychosis.
Oh, nice victory roll.
Roll up. Well, no referee. One, two, three. Moving to Guerrera with the three count, but referee Charles Robinson down and out.
Well, someone has to do it.
But he's not a WCW official.
See, that's
well, there is none around.
Look at this. Juventud has brought the belt into the ring, proclaiming him as the new champion, but.
Well, Charles Robinson's still in charge here.
It looks like Charles Robinson is saying that the Prince, the artist formerly known as Prince Iaukea, is the one that caused the collision with the referee. And he's giving the belt back to the Prince.
That's not right. It's not bad, though, but it's not right. You know, think about it, it is right. The man earned it.
It's going to be a disqualification victory is what it's going to be. Let's hear it exactly as Charles Robinson comes over to Dave Penger, our ring announcer. And hello once again, everyone. From titles will be at stake for the very first time ever on Thunder. It's an all-out tag war. The tag team champions, the Mamalukes, with their manager, the Disco Inferno, will put the gold on the line in an 8-man, 4-corners elimination tag match. The other teams, the Harlem Heat, plus the duo of Booker and Billy Kidman. And how about this? They're out of the slammer. The freshly paroled Harris brothers. Brain, this is one field of eight that promises plenty of action. The tag team titles of the Mamalukes will at one apiece. And coming up next, check this out. The big man's on his way to the arena. The Wall coming up next on Thunder.
We're not just big dumb goofers.
Uh-oh. The Wall set to go one-on-one with Crowbar. It's next on TBS. Hey, Mean Gene, don't let your job get in the way of a good time.
He's in Camelot now.
Now, how does Okerlund get those cushy gigs?
And I get you.
Yet I get a guitar shot from Jeff Jarrett. What's going on around here?
I'm the figure four.
You had to remind me.
This is a strange bird right here.
Would you say that maybe he was wired a little differently at birth?
I thought I was.
I've seen that mentioned in the past as describing you, but I think it's pretty appropriate for Crowbar as well. Set to go one-on-one with the Huge Wall. We talked about the on sales for this weekend. This Friday, tickets for the Johnstown, Pennsylvania show of April 1st. This Saturday, Thunder in Durham, New Hampshire. Tickets on sale, as well as Nitro in Worcester, Massachusetts. You can meet the Nitro girls in both Durham and Worcester from 10 a.m. to noon this Saturday, March the 4th. And look at Crowbar on the attack at the outset. Couple of quick shots to the wall, and I think that's great strategy. Slingshot into a crossbody block, takes the wall down on the floor.
Good strategy. The last thing you want is the wall to start putting those big meat hooks on you. Stay on him, just like he's doing right now. I think this is the first time, Mike, we've seen the arms on the wall. We know how big his feet are and his back and his height, but look at the arms on the guy.
I think you're right, and I'm still thinking of that vicious choke slam that the wall has used to rack up quite an impressive string of victories as of late. One that just came to mind was the Beast from the East, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Well, this wall just keeps getting better and better, and so does Crowbar. Oh.
Big boot to the face, David Flair.
Uh-oh.
What's he doing in there?
I guess he's ready to go up in the air.
And about ready to come down on the receiving end of one of those choke slams that we just talked about. Well, that'll clear the ring. Now, whoa. Turning his attention back to Crowbar and that momentary distraction as David Flair got into the ring, allows Crowbar to connect with a dropkick. Did you see that? Between the ring ropes.
Here he comes with a chair.
And, oh, God.
Did you hear that?
Here, and they're 3 feet away from us.
His hair will never grow in that spot again.
A thud. But we already know that Crowbar will put his own body at risk. Oh, in order to deliver an offensive move, and that's just what he did. Running off the apron and connecting with the big splash
on the
floor. But
look at the wall's getting up. He may be getting up slowly, but he's getting up. Right in front of us. Almost too close sometimes.
Trying to clear the cobwebs, trying to regroup.
But you gotta give Crowbar credit. He took it to this big man, and he's been in charge since the beginning.
Now Crowbar meets him there on the ring apron. We're going to try and suplex him back into the ring. Oh, look at that strength.
That's just sheer power.
Front suplex by the wall sends Crowbar down. Wall headed up to the top.
Whoa.
No, Crowbar ready. Caught him with a dropkick. Just momentarily stunned this big man. Series of right hands. Crowbar really laying him in there.
This man Wall is so dangerous.
Oh, wait a minute. Got him throttled. Wait a minute. What's he looking down here for? What's going on here?
No, not here.
Are you crazy?
Not here.
Are you crazy? Where's the referee?
Keep him in the ring.
Get this guy. Look out. Good God. Oh, my God. He just choke slammed Crowbar directly through the broadcast position.
My arm.
I've never seen anything like that.
Wait a minute, let me go see what's happening here.
Bobby Heenan taking his headset off to check on Crowbar.
Need some help. Oh,
we definitely need some help. Referee Billy Silverman. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me now? No, he can't hear me.
We're back live now, and we see that Crowbar, as we return live here on Thunder, is being wheeled out of the arena here in Fargo, North Dakota. I think we've got, check this monitor. Look at this, Brain. Oh, my God.
I've never seen anything like that in my life. From the ring apron, by wall, right through our table. Look at this. Great camera work by our crew.
Yeah, but can you imagine the extent of the injury suffered by Crowbar? Look there, you see the TV monitors. Everything just as he crashed through. I've never seen anything like that.
Mike, I leaned over him when he was down there. Look at this again. Here's another shot of it. I looked and he was down on the ground here, laying here. His eyes were wide open, and there was a funny noise coming out, a gurgling sound. He's had internal injuries. He's hurt bad.
This wall, he's just uncontrollable. Never seen anything like that from the wall.
You know, his career may be over. Look at this again. From the apron, by a 375-pound man through that table. Unbelievable.
Unbelievable, the impact as he went through the broadcast table here. Let's take a look at the bad blood involving Hulk Hogan and Team Pac. Let's take it, guys, please.
I'm here with a young man who is celebrating Mardi Gras. For a good reason, yesterday, of course, was Fat Tuesday. I'm talking about the raging Cajun Lash LaRue. Things a little quiet right now for you, however, Lash.
Well, you know, Gene, I know things haven't been exactly spectacular for the raging Cajun lately, but I got legions and legions of loyal Lash lovers, and I can guarantee we'll begin to see great things out of Lash LaRue. I'm just happy to be a part of WCW right now, and I'll do anything for those WCW fans.
Well, of course, Get him out of here.
Hey, wait a minute. That's Dustin Rhodes just busting up that interview with Mean Gene and Lash LaRue. What's going on here?
Well, Dustin Rhodes is doing what he wants to do. He's tired of being pushed around. He's tired of being put on the shelf. He's going to make a name for himself. He's going to let everybody know what the Rhodes name is all about. It's about Dustin Rhodes.
Oh, and he just sent the raging Cajun Lash LaRue chest first into that steel safety rail.
So what?
What are you talking about, so what? What the heck? Referee Charles Robinson has come out to the ring, and this is an unscheduled match. This is not any lineup that I have. Cross body block, Lash for the cover, and gets a two count on Dustin Rhodes.
Well, it's thunder. Let's just watch and see what happens, Mike.
You're right. Unpredictable as always. Nice elevation with the back body drop by Lash. Follows up in the corner, catches him with one right hand. Series of rights now to the side of the head of Dustin Rhodes. And Dustin Rhodes and Terry Funk, they are going to go at it. And Uncensored 2000 and Dustin from south of the border connected. And the Cajun going to try and fight it off. Rhodes just throws him halfway across the ring.
Now, can you imagine that match with him and Terry Funk? Can you imagine the chairs, the ring, the steps, the tables? Everything goes here.
Think about the bad blood through the years between the Funks and the Rhodes. This goes back to Dustin's father and Terry Funk, and he just caught him with that bulldog and drove him down to the mat and scored the three count.
He got him.
And he's not satisfied with a victory in this unscheduled match. And here comes the hardcore legend Terry Funk, and he's got the chicken with him.
The chicken is with Funk.
We saw it Monday on Nitro. Terry Funk has got the chicken in his hand. He just hit Dustin Rhodes on the side of the head, just winds up and got him again.
As only Terry Funk can do.
I was waiting for you to call it a foul ball, Brain.
I'm not that way. Got him again. Want an extra crispy or original? Look at this. Look at Terry Funk.
He's got the chicken wrapped around the left hand. And he just knocked him out.
With a chicken, as only Terry Funk can do.
Terry Funk and Dustin Rhodes, who will square off on March the 19th at Uncensored.
Wait a minute.
And we don't have to wait until then.
It's not over yet. Terry Funk may be eating that chicken before Dustin's done with him.
Look at that. Dustin turning his attention to the chicken. He dropped the elbow on the chicken, and then he's hitting Funk with it in the head. Thunder continues to be the craziest, most unpredictable program in wrestling.
Boy, you're right about that. We got two of them. Toughest guys that ever came out of Texas. I'm talking about Funk and Rhodes. You got a chicken involved. They're going into the stands. What is the pay-per-view going to be like, Mike?
It's going to be off the charts, and Terry Funk is going to follow Dustin Rhodes into the crowd.
Well, you think this is the first time Terry Funk's ever fought in the aisles or outdoors or in the parking lot?
Not the first and not the
Sunday in Miami at Uncensored, the WCW Tag Team titles on the line against the Harris Boys. But before that, tonight, here on Thunder, six other men will be vying for those titles. What about it, Mama Luke?
Hey, hi, Thunder Betty! hanging up on
me. The manager of champions has booked a match tonight against six guys to prove that these guys are the toughest tag team in WCW with my guidance.
Johnny the Bull.
All I want to do is break some thumbs, Mean Gene. That's it.
Hey, this is how it's going to go, okay? You can put 600 guys in the ring. We're the Pisons, the toughest tag team in WCW. We're the champs. Harris boys, beware. Uncensored, we're coming after you, and we're going to knock the Fozzie Nukes out of you.
Respect that.
And we are back at ringside, and still to come in this broadcast, the U.S. title will be at stake. Vampiro challenging Jeff Jarrett for that United States Championship, but Brain up next. Very unique matchup. Eight men involved in a four corners elimination bout with the tag team titles at stake. And listen to these rules. Anyone in the ring can tag anyone else in. Once one member of a team has been eliminated, both members must go to the back, and the match will continue until one team is left, and they will be the World Tag Team Champs.
I knew that. Were you trying to tell me something I don't know? You got eight guys in there that are going to take each other's heads off. This is going to be great. I knew that.
And the Mama Lukes are going to put those belts on the line. You hear that music? Here come the Mama Lukes and the Disco Inferno, the reigning World Tag Team Champions. The challengers in this matchup will be the Harris Brothers, the team of Harlem Heat, as well as Kidman and Booker joining forces. So three challenging teams taking their shot at the Mama Lukes and the tag team gold.
Only here at WCW you're going to see something like this.
And this past Monday on Nitro, we saw the Harris Brothers do it again. The H-bomb on Johnny the Bull. Then they turned their attention to the manager of champions. Disco Inferno H-bomb. They had handcuffed Big Vito to the corner. They put the boots to him and look at that. Then they even turned their attention to security and the police, and it got thrown him into jail.
Well, they're out and they're here, and something's gonna happen tonight.
They're going to challenge for the World Tag Team titles. Yes, three challenging teams. And this is the first of the challengers as the Harris Brothers head to the ring representing the NWO.
How would you like these two guys coming to your house looking for you and you hold something?
No, thank you.
No, thank you. You're right.
A personal animosity as of late between the Harris Brothers and the Mama Lukes, and the Mama Lukes even telling Mean Gene Okerlund that they would put the belts up against 600 guys if it meant that, well, they would get a crack at the Harris Boys.
Well, they don't back down from anybody. These are two big, 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 tough guys.
And this matchup already underway. I didn't hear a bell. There's the bell. I guess the match is officially underway.
We don't need a bell.
With just the first two of four teams involved is the Harris Brothers, the Brothers of the Mama Lukes. Turn it up, and that's Harlem Heat's music. Harlem Heat getting ready to make their way from the back aisle in the ring. Harris Brothers, with their attention firmly focused on the tag champs, here comes Stevie Ray, Big T, accompanied by the huge, the monstrous Cash and Mr. Biggs, Harlem Heat 2000 as they call themselves.
Look at the size of the arms on this man, Cash.
Oh, we knew this was going to be absolutely wild, absolutely out of control, and it certainly has been. And it's a night of unexpected visitors, I guess. Jay Biggs is the next to join us here at the broadcast position.
Mr. Biggs, welcome.
Ian, thank you very much. Today it's all your pleasure. You know, this is right down Harlem Heat's alley. This is what we like. And let me tell you something about this Booker here. He just doesn't seem to be able to make a butt-whipping stick. It's just like Teflon. He doesn't get it.
Well, Booker out to the ring. His partner, Billy Kidman, is yet to appear.
Kidman, that lightweight.
What an axe kick from Booker to his own brother, Stevie Ray. But now you see they turn their attention to Stevie Ray, and Big Vito put the boots to Booker.
And let me tell you something, they're angry. You want to know why they're angry? Because they've been hard-pressed. They've been suppressed, oppressed, and depressed. Everything is just going wrong, but we're going to make it all right, even if we have to just beat it into everybody. You understand what I'm saying to you today?
Well, huge opportunity for Harlem Heat in this matchup to win the World Tag Team title. Jericho, the manager of champions, then hit the cross body block on Vito.
Mike, this is like a battle royal. There's no rules. Nobody can be controlled. The referee don't know what to do in there. Just let him go.
Turn him loose. That's all you can do.
That's exactly why this works to the benefit of Harlem Heat. This is right down our alley.
This has to be a huge advantage for Harlem Heat.
I mean, just look at the scales of justice. 350 pounds and 300 pounds respectively. Who can overcome those insurmountable odds? Can you tell me today who can do it?
And don't forget to factor in this huge man cash at ringside as well.
Are you telling me that Big T and Steve Ray need help? Are you telling me that?
Uncensored, the countdown continues to the next big World Championship Wrestling pay-per-view event. Again, the World Tag Team titles at stake in this matchup. It's been an absolutely wild brawl. Finally, we're getting some semblance of order out here with the other teams going out to the ring apron. It's about time.
No, that wasn't the reason why you have order. You have order because Harlem Heat has taken control. That's why you have order. Give due where it's due there today.
You know, you're right, Mr. Biggs. They controlled this match. They made sure everyone had...
Well, it looks like Harlem Heat not on the same page. Well, communication problems there. How about that, Mr. Biggs? Side kick from Booker. Russian leg sweep. Cover. Two, three.
How about he got him.
Harlem Heat's been eliminated.
That was a fast count. Something's... Wait.
Those are the words of the Disco Inferno.
That means they both have to leave now. Right, Mike?
Both members of Harlem Heat have to leave this matchup. Oh, we got to take a break.
No, no.
World's tag title on the line when we return. No. Welcome back, everyone, to Thunder on the Superstation TBS. We're joined by the Disco Inferno at ringside. What a wild eight-man, four corners elimination. Yeah. And just moments ago, we saw the first team eliminated as the Harlem Heat, no longer a factor in this matchup, Disco.
Yeah, absolutely. And Booker intentionally kicked Kidman. I knew they couldn't survive as a tag team in there. During the break, we saw the fall. It's down to the Harris boys and my boys. Come on, guys, you got to win this, for crying out loud. I booked this thing thinking that we would be no problem. And maybe these other guys would beat each other up. All right, there we go. Hold him out. Boom! Yeah! We're on him now. There we go. Pin him!
Now back to the action. Disco cheers on the Mamalukes.
That's Pisons! Will you get it straight? You guys keep calling us Mamalukes. We're Pisons. Who keeps doing this? Bobby, you know who's doing this?
Cover!
It's Tanay. It's Pison. It's very simple. Disco tells you it's Pison. It's Pison.
All right, all right.
This is ridiculous. This is almost a disaster.
You should get Pison tattooed on your forehead so you remember it.
Has any tag teams in WCW ever beaten three tag teams in one match?
Not that I know of, Disco.
Well, the manager of champions is trying to make it happen. I'm making things happen here in WCW. Look at this. What are they doing? Are they cheating? Come on, Tanay. Call the action.
It's now down.
Out loud.
I can't get a word in edgewise with you and Heenan just agreeing with each other blindlessly out here.
Oh, you're the only one that knows what's happening, huh, Tanay?
Harris brothers turning their attention to Johnny the Bull with the double team tactics in the corner.
Come on, Ronnie, one more time, big rock.
Disco Inferno. Disco, what are you doing? Charles Robinson trying to get Disco Inferno. What do you mean you're going to interfere here?
I'm trying to get the referee straight here. These referees at WCW are atrocious. I'm trying to be a manager, I'm trying to be a guidance instructor, a genius all at the same time. Look at that. Come on, Johnny.
Whoa!
Oh, he can take that. Johnny the Bull, 22 years old. He has nose broken six times already.
That was just today.
He got his nose broken six more times today?
Probably. He gets in fights every time I've seen him. He's always beating up somebody out back.
Just a love fest here between you and Disco Inferno, isn't it, Heenan?
Well, if you don't like it, boy. Why don't you take a walk?
Yeah, Bobby, me and you make a good team here. Why don't we get rid of today?
Boy, and you can teach me a few dance steps? Yeah, we can
hey,
do
sure,
it.
Sure, no problem. I'll take you out sometime.
Yeah, you guys would be great. Meanwhile, in the ring, Harris brothers continue their demolition of the World Tag Team Champions.
Come on, Bull.
Double elbow off the double team. Johnny the Bull down.
Well, it's down to this now. The Harris brothers and the World Tag Team Champions.
I managed somehow with my intellectual capability to get the fans behind these guys. The fans are firmly in support of the Pisons because of me.
To the ropes. Johnny the Bull ducks the clothesline.
Oh!
Yes.
Connects with a spin kick. Never more important, Disco, than for Johnny the Bull to get to the corner and get the fresh man, Big Vito, in.
Get him in there.
He's
come on,
make
Bull.
Make that tag.
Make the tag, Bull. Come on. Oh, no, the other Harris guys. There's Big Vito. Come on, Big Vito. Boom. Boom.
Running clotheslines.
Yeah.
Oh, he's on fire. Yeah.
Come on, Big Fit.
What's going on?
Call the action.
Big Vito and Johnny the Bull.
Whoa.
Big scoop and a slam.
He's going upstairs.
He's going
now,
up
Mike.
Top. Come on, Vito.
Big Vito headed to the top rope.
Here it is. Here it is. Boom. Yeah. Woohoo. We win.
Caught him with the big elbow. Referee Robinson down for two.
Oh, come on.
Save at the last second.
What's going on here?
Tag team title still in jeopardy here, Disco. Now the Harris brothers.
Well, what is he doing?
Johnny the Bull sent into the ropes. He ducks the clothesline.
What is he doing?
H-bomb! H-bomb!
We're going to have new world tag team champions.
Right now, Mike, right now.
Disco with the belt. World tag team title belt to the back of the head. You see the interference from the manager of champions. Johnny the Bull with his arm draped over the chest of the pro Harris brother.
Is this man ecstatic? Is he beside himself? And rightly so. He's engineered another win for his tag team champion. You gotta take your hat off to the guy and give him credit.
How lucky can you be if you're the Mamalukes? They remain world tag team champions thanks to the interference of the Disco Inferno. And now the Harris brothers are gonna turn it around.
Uh-oh.
Johnny the Bull, Big Vito sent out to the floor. Disco to the ropes and...
H-Bomb City!
For the manager of champions!
Tag him and bag him, he's out.
And the Harris brothers, they'll get another chance at the tag team titles upcoming at Uncensored 2000 on Sunday, March the 19th, and they certainly deserve that return match.
But will Disco be awake at that time? Who knows?
Oh, I don't know. Let's go back to Gene.
All right, Mike and Bobby, I thank you very much. The one thing I noticed in that four corners, eight-man elimination tag team match was the very disappointing performance of the new and improved Harlem Heat. If this is the real deal,
then... What the hell are you talking about?
Why,
what you mean?
Saying?
It was not a, you know, that was a two count. But then you said, you know me, Gene, I'm up to here with you. I'm up to people like Bobby Heenan. I'm up to people, you, Tony Schiavone, the whole crew. Man, you need to start getting things right. That was a two count, and I'm telling you right now, just like I'm telling everybody at the board of directors of WCW, I want Booker, I want that 130-pound pipsqueak Kidman, and I want his squacking yak with him. And I'm saying, and you said you want to be the bearer of bad news. Since you want to be a messenger, Pop,
right.
You go tell them
the
you
want to match it.
I'm
going
to hurt somebody.
Please.
Going to hurt somebody.
We are out of time, gentlemen.
We look at somebody.
Sorry.
You
we're
get them suckers out here right now.
Monday night, Diamond Dallas Page guested on the Late Late Show with Craig Kilborn. Now, Diamond Dallas not only talked about his book Positively Page, but he also addressed his recent injuries.
Hey, you have an announcement? What's that? You hurt? What's going on?
Well,
you injured?
It's not really an announcement or whatever. You know, in wrestling, you know, you can't fake gravity.
Right. You guys go down hard from way up there.
It's not really the flying. It's sort of that sudden stop, you know? And I ruptured a couple discs in my back, and that's why I've been out. That's why I've been off the show. I've been, you know, in wrestling, you know, all of a sudden you'll see a guy disappear for like 2 or 3 months or whatever, and people wonder, well, where are they? They're hurt.
Yeah.
I push myself to the limit. You know, everybody knows that I'm out there. You know, I give it everything I got, and at some point you're going to break. And right now I've been off for about 4 weeks, and right now, you know, I don't know if I want to come back.
Here comes the U.S. champ, Jeff Jarrett, the chosen one, along with the NWO girls on his way to the arena. And here's the challenger, Vampiro, with a chance to prove that he belongs with the elite of WCW, because it's coming up next. U.S. heavyweight title at stake. The chosen one, Jeff Jarrett, puts the gold on the line against the challenge of Vampiro. It's next here on Thunder on the Superstation TBS.
Nitro Girl. Log on.
NitroGirls.com.
I'm Sky. Chameleon.
I'm Baby.
I'm Chiquita.
I am Spice.
Tigress.
NitroGirls.com.
This is it, the moment of truth. This This is what we've been waiting for, what we've been building to all night. The United States Heavyweight Championship at stake. And here's the chosen one, the U.S. title holder, Jeff Jarrett and the NWO ladies.
Well, he means business. He wants to walk down that aisle, not only wearing the U.S. title, but also the Heavyweight Championship of the world.
Right, it was last week on Nitro, where we saw Vampiro and Jeff Jarrett. There was interference by the Harris brothers in that match that allowed Jeff Jarrett to score the win. It's time for the return bout. It went down Monday at Nitro. Problems again involving these two. And it's time now for the return match here on Thunder. And when will you hear about this blockbuster announcement that I've just been told during the last break? Guess who's going to be in Providence, Rhode Island this upcoming Monday for Nitro?
You mean this Monday in Providence?
This Monday.
Well, you got me. Who?
Strap on your seatbelts. Hulk Hogan and Sting will both be in Providence Monday night.
This coming Monday?
Now, ladies, you do realize I have a U.S. title defense tonight against a freak in the Vampiro, right? What do you girls want to get freaky tonight? You want to give him a little something extra as a distraction? Do you want to flash Vampiro? No, no, not yet, not yet, not yet, not yet. I tell you what, do each and every one of you people want to see Tylene, Kim, and Medasia give Vampiro a little something extra?
Yes!
Not a damn chance.
Sorry.
All three of you, get your slap ass back to my dressing room where you belong.
He doesn't want to share the spotlight with anybody.
He's the boss. He's the chosen one.
You know, Brain, in light of that blockbuster announcement that we just made involving Hulk Hogan and Sting, both being at Nitro this upcoming Monday in Providence, Rhode Island, I just can't believe that the Total Package and Ric Flair are so worried about their petty jealousies involving AA Arn Anderson. Flair and Luger better concentrate on Hogan and Sting, who will be in Providence this Monday night for Nitro.
Well, you just heard about it, and no doubt they've heard about it too. So this Monday, all hell will break loose. You know that. You take Hogan, you take Flair, you take Sting, you take Luger, and you put them in a building together. And I'll tell you something, you can't keep the roof on the joint.
Certainly going to be an explosive Nitro this upcoming Monday from Providence, Rhode Island. Vampiro to the ring, and the bell sounds. This U.S. title bout is underway. To the ropes, Vampiro springs off, drops Jarrett with a clothesline. What has to be going through the mind of Vampiro with this golden opportunity go to the top and get the U.S. title, Brian?
I'll tell you, he realizes it. He knows what he has to do. He's gone through Flair. He's gone through Luger. Now he has another shot at this man right here. Oh, and he's not going to waste an opportunity, believe me.
The slingshot into the cross body block by Vampiro. Yes, 11 days away from Uncensored, where Jeff Jarrett gets a shot at the world's heavyweight title as we see Vampiro, look out, taking Jarrett and putting him right into our broadcast table. Regroup, Brain, you all right?
Huh? It's dark under this table.
Back in the ring, incredible intensity and focus. Vampiro cover two and... oh, so close. Just a split second away. Look out. Here come the Harris brothers.
That's not good news.
You got to stay
out. Believe me, for Vampiro.
Vampiro had been like a man possessed in this matchup, totally dominating from the opening bell, but the distraction of the Harris brothers allowed Jarrett to hit him from behind.
And the referee doesn't see a thing. Jarrett's got his body all turned around.
Hey, get back up.
No, you stay
up. Vampiro back up to the ring apron. Jarrett's going to try and bring him in. The float over by Vampiro. The waist lock. Jarrett fighting it off with elbows. Shot to the side of the head. Jarrett hooks the top rope. And turned him inside out with a running clothesline.
Boy, did he ever. Almost took him out of his shoes. Sid Vicious, watch this man. Watch this man, Jeff Jarrett. He's got his sights set on you and that championship.
And we've already seen Jeff Jarrett in tag team matches score the pinfall win over Sid Vicious. Can he do it one-on-one with the world's title at stake at Uncensored 2000? Again, U.S. title on the line here in this matchup. The go-behind quick roll-up by Vampiro gets two from Nick Patrick and only two before Jarrett kicks out.
He's going upstairs now.
And Jarrett cut him off with a right hand, sending Vampiro flying all the way down to the safety rail in a steel chair. And again, the Harris brothers interfere.
Oh. They don't play around, these Harris brothers. They mean business.
Now the Harrises are going to roll in.
Wait a minute, Mike.
Wait a minute. Mama Luke's out. Big Vito and Johnny the Bull in a brawl out here on the arena floor. Meanwhile, in the ring, Vampiro decks the clothesline. It's a gurry kick to the back of the head. The champion, Jarrett, gets to his feet. Where'd the referee go? There's Nick Patrick. One, two, three.
He had him. He had him.
Oh, Vampiro, by all rights, should be the new U.S. champ.
He had him, Mike.
Referee Patrick distracted when the Mama Lukes came out to ringside to take care of the Harris brothers. You see the concern on the face of Jarrett. He's lost his backup.
Yeah, but Jarrett's a competitor. He's been there before. He knows what to do.
Look out.
He's got a chair.
Steel chair in hand. Nick Patrick, fortunately, takes it away.
But,
Jarrett connects with the DDT.
But is that enough to beat the man?
One, two, and still fight left in Vampiro. Able to kick out at two.
Tonight.
So important to Vampiro. The U.S. title on the line, a chance to really make a name for himself. Inside
kick.
One, two.
Oh.
Jarrett kicks out again at two.
And I'll tell you, Mike, the whole wrestling world is looking at this man, Vampiro. They're
another
watching.
Roll up, two, and again, Jarrett able to kick out.
Just after the last couple matches he's had, he has opened everyone's eyes.
Oh, ooh. Turns around. Oh, referee Patrick collides with Vampiro and goes out to the floor. In the ring, the snap suplex by Jarrett.
Doesn't matter, there's no referee.
Where's Jarrett headed? Out to get the U.S. title belt from ringside. Referee Dick Patrick still down. And Jarrett stopped by Vampiro. Vampiro takes him down. Catapulted into the corner.
You want a belt?
Vampiro's got the belt. There goes Jarrett.
We got a new U.S. champion. We got a new U.S. champion.
Count along. One, two, three. Wait a minute. Two.
What's going on here? He had his bell rung.
Senior official Nick Patrick apparently overruling. Wait a minute. Oh, there's the stroke by Jarrett. Vampiro face first into the title belt. Two and
he got him.
Three and oh, I don't believe it. How fortunate can Jeff Jarrett be? He is truly the chosen one. But the question is, how much longer can Vampiro be denied the U.S. title? Now what? Harris Brothers out. Is that the spray paint?
They're gonna do a number on him. I smell H-bomb.
To the ropes, and of course.
Oh,
God, the H-bomb on Vampiro, and
time for a trip to the body shop.
The NWO celebration. Jarrett and the Harris Brothers. Jarrett already scoring the win here to retain the U.S. title. Can you imagine what Nitro's going to be like Monday in Providence, Rhode Island?
Put Hogan and
Sunday in Providence, Rhode Island.
Put Hogan and Sting.
You just keep watching. We'll see you Monday in Providence, Rhode Island. Hulk Hogan and Sting will be there, but so will Ric Flair. So will the Total Package and Arn Anderson. We'll be right back. the most unpredictable and outrageous WCW event of the year 2000 is this Sunday on pay-per-view, and tonight we expect that tense and emotional atmosphere to reach a boiling point. You are looking at George Mason University's Patriot Center. We're in Fairfax, Virginia. From ringside, it's your TBS primetime broadcast team. Mike Tenay, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and Brain, there's so much at stake this Sunday in Miami, Florida, that I guess it's only natural that everyone is on edge this close to Uncensored 2000.
Oh, you're right about that. Just walking through the backstage area, you could just cut the tension with a knife. Everybody's uptight. Everybody's on everybody's case. You can tell. The big one's coming. The big pay-per-view for WCW. You can smell it. Something big is going to happen.
And we kick things off this week on Thunder with tag team action. There's the chairman of WCW, La Parca, and he's joined by the third-generation wrestler. There he is, Chavo Guerrero Jr. Wait a minute. La Parca with the microphone?
Let's listen.
May need a translator.
The Skull Captain's in the his house. You see the chair, you know the deal, you know the 411. One for me and one for my homies.
You know, the last time that I saw such obvious lip syncing, Three Count was singing.
Are you saying this man isn't speaking his own words?
That's not La Parca.
Well, who do you think it is? He's the guy with the mask. That's La Parca.
I'm not sure who it was that was doing the actual talking.
Oh, you got to know everything, don't you?
Well, not everything. Tag team of El Dandy, and there you see Silver King, his tag team partner. What is this all about? Awfully concerned about his grooming.
Well, a person should be. Nothing wrong with that.
Now what?
Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize. I stand corrected. Introducing Latin America's most desirable.
Los Fabulosos.
Latin America's most desirable man. According to who? Who took a vote on that?
Well, don't get up in my face about it. I don't know. Look at him. They come in the building. You see all the women rush to them. They want them to sign autographs. What must you think happens to them when they're back home, south of the border? They're idols. Everyone idolizes these guys.
And we're off and running on Thunder with this tag team action involving the Luchadors. We expect this to be an all-action matchup. Plenty of high-risk moves. El Dandy to start it off with Chavo Jr. And as we've seen in the past with El Dandy, one half of Los Fabulosos, he has a terrific right hand. One of the best right hands in the business. Chavo Jr. and La Parca are going to have to be very wary of that. Nice elevation. Whoa. By Chavo Jr. The back body drop, and he took him all the way to the floor. Now Chavo's going to go airborne, actually slides under the bottom rope. Dandy able to avoid him. And Chavo Jr. to follow up the advantage on the floor. Now going to bring him back into the ring.
Well, that's the only way to beat the man, in the ring. Throw him back in there. Oh!
Telegraph of the back body drop by Chavo Jr. Dandy connects with the kick. Both men tag in their partners. It's now La Parca and Silver King. The shoulder block by Silver King immediately goes for the pinfall cover. Not even an opportunity for referee Silverman to get down and employ a count.
Well, he's trying to win this match the quick way, real fast.
A head and shoulders fake for Silver King and a clothesline for Dandy. But as soon as La Parca turns around, he's taken down to the mat with a clothesline from the King.
Now take him apart, guys.
Los Fabulosos, the fabulous ones of Mexico.
Oh!
Great snap on the slam by La Parca. Dandy tried the senton, caught his own tag partner.
They've all gone nuts in there.
They don't have far to go.
No, they don't. I like this kind of action.
The chairman loves to strut. Dandy and Silver King ready for him. Well, La Parca able to avoid that move, and Silver King just drop-kicked his own tag partner to the floor.
Look at this. Look at that. Oh, talk about suicide.
Twisting into a cross-body block by La Parca, crashing into Dandy on the arena floor. You hear that? Use the chair is what the fans are chanting to the chairman of WCW, La Parca.
Well, they like to see him part somebody's hair with those metal chairs. I like to see it.
Dropkick by Chavo Jr. Silver came to the floor, and there the slingshot into the crossbody block by Chavo connects.
Well, those moves are so dangerous. I mean, it has to be, you have to be right on the money. If you're off a couple inches, you're done.
La Parca for the cover gets two, and Dandy got the shoulder up. Thought he had him that time.
Oh. They heard that back in Mexico City.
Open hand slap, just the sound of it reverberating all through the arena. La Parca went to put the shoulder into Dandy and went all the way through to the steel ring post. Now Silver King and Dandy, double team, a double leapfrog, double drop toe hold. Oh, they just sandwiched La Parca. What a stiff kick from Silver King. To the ropes, Silver King plants him, dropped him on his head with the DDT. Hook of the leg gets two, and Chavo Jr. in to break it up.
Barely made the save. That's the only thing that saved him from not losing this match.
Dandy in that famous right hand, and then a headbutt for Chavo Jr. sends him out to the floor. Los Fabulosos, Silver King and Dandy have taken control of this opening tag bout here on Thunder.
They're a good tag team. They work well together.
Off the right hand, a scoop and a backbreaker by Dandy. Now, from the outside, the slingshot in. And Silver King follows up by driving an elbow across the chest of Chavo Guerrero Jr. Now what?
Where is Chavo going to go? Or land?
Well, I was going to say wherever Dandy wanted to take him, but now La Parca slips underneath. Dandy up in a precarious position. Chavo Jr. hit the crossbody block on Silver King. There's just no predicting where the luchadors are going to fly.
But one thing you can predict, they're going to be flying.
Chavo Jr. Oh, the tornado DDT out of the corner. Hook of the leg. The shoulders are down, and he did get him. He got the three count. Chavo Guerrero Jr. and La Parca with the opening bout tag team victory here on Thunder as they get the win over Los Fabulosos.
Look, guys, I think you just might need a little guidance and some new clothes because, you know, clothes really do make the man.
Do you think? Why would you like to help us out of these clothes?
Let's go shopping.
Come on. Let's do it.
You understand? Hey, Joto! Este campeón es mío, eh? Give that to the man! Hey! Who is that? Hey! You guys bring it! Stop it! Shut up! Shut up, all of you, man! What happened last week? It's not gonna happen tonight! Psychosis, Kaz, you guys have a match tonight. Everyone else, you're banned from ringside! Get out of here! Go! Move it! Move it! Do you not understand it? Move it! Get out of here, all of you! Go!
Hulk Hogan wants both members of Team Package.
That's what I heard.
Is he thinking straight? You asked earlier about Jimmy Hart thinking straight. I'm wondering about Hulk Hogan. Or did Team Package just bait the trap for Hogan and Hart?
Well, they know how Hogan reacts. They know how Hogan's ego is. And this may have worked out good for them.
1 week ago on Nitro, the Artist interfered in a number one contender's bout for his Cruiserweight Championship. You just saw where he hit Psychosis with the title belt. That allowed Kaz Hayashi to roll Psychosis up for the win, and as a result of that, because of that interference from the Artist, the winner of this match, this return between Psychosis and Kaz Hayashi, will go on to Uncensored this Sunday, and he will gain a shot to win the Psychosis.
Mike, right here, take a look at Psychosis' elbow. Look at the bruises on his arm. Look at they're all skinned up, how the bones are just, got water on each elbow. The beating these luchadors take is amazing.
And of course, referee Charles Robinson really laying down the law, as we saw before we went to the break. No one allowed at ringside for this matchup between Psychosis and Kaz Hayashi. Boy, I just wonder about Hogan.
Well, I know what I'm going to be doing in 4 days.
Well, it's Uncensored 2000. It's what everybody's going to be doing.
You don't want to miss this one. Just the name, Uncensored. What could that mean? Knowing the state of mind everybody's at right now?
And think about that strap match involving Hulk Hogan and Ric Flair. And I know Bobby Heenan, during your active wrestling career, as we see Kaz Hayashi go for a quick cover, you participated in many strap matches. Take us into the battle, if you will. What can Flair and Hogan expect at Uncensored?
Well, I'll tell you, when you're in a strap match, you've got that 10-foot piece of leather strapped around your wrist and strapped around your opponent's wrist. There's no way out of there. There's no way to get away. He can pull you in the ring. You can't. And when that rope, and I mean that rawhide gets wet, that just cuts into your body, cuts into your flesh, it's horrible. And when you get snapped with that leather belt, it just tears on you. You're hurt for months. It's horrible. It is horrible. And there's no preparation you can do for that. Just get in there and try to survive.
Quick cover off the suplex there by Kaz Hayashi, only able to get a two count on Psychosis. Again, the winner of this bout goes on to Uncensored this Sunday in Miami, Florida. And the winner of this match gets a shot at the Cruiserweight title against The Artist into the corner. Kaz Hayashi runs right into a back elbow from Psychosis. Gonna set Kaz now up on the top rope. And gonna bring him back in with the Frankensteiner. Brought him back in and hooks the leg. Gets one, gets two, and Kaz Hayashi able to kick out and avoid the pinfall.
Have you noticed this, Mike? It's early in the evening. And have you noticed the emotions here by everybody? Oh. How tense everyone is. I mean, this is like a funeral here. People don't know what to do. People don't know what to say. They don't know how to act because it's 4 days away.
Quick roll up by Psychosis, almost out of the blue, man. And he scored the pin, and he scored the win. And as a result, Psychosis will go on this Sunday at Uncensored 2000, just 4 days away to get a shot at the Artist and the Cruiserweight title. Kaz Hayashi disappointed, but there you see extending the hand of respect. And here comes the Artist from behind now with the attack on Psychosis.
Whoa.
Those chops. The match is over that we saw with Psychosis winning the bout. And then the Artist coming down after the matchup. He's got the title belt. Oh.
And these are the two men who will be fighting for the title in just 4 days. If there's anything left of them.
That's the move that won him the Cruiserweight title. That jumping DDT off the middle ropes, and he just planted Psychosis face first on the Thunder logo. The title is at stake this Sunday, in addition to so many more important matchups. But now let's go backstage to Gene Okerlund.
It's this Sunday in Miami at Uncensored. You're going to be facing Terry Funk one-on-one in a bull rope match. But first things first, tonight here on Thunder, it's a very dangerous Billy Kidman.
Why isn't it Funk? Tell you what. Hey, Funk, you by the guts. Sunday night, you can't run anymore. This cowbell right here and this bull rope, I'm going to wrap around your head and cut you completely in two. Billy Kidman, tonight, you've never seen a Rhodes in this form. You've never. You better forget. You ever heard the word the American dream? Because tonight, I'm your American nightmare, and you're gonna pay if you bite the dust.
Wow, the American nightmare. And in addition to that matchup, coming up next, Billy Kidman, accompanied by the lovely Tori Wilson. They're on their way to the arena, because here on the Superstation, Kidman will face Dustin Rhodes next on Thunder. We talked about Thunder in Orlando next Tuesday. We'll close out the month of March on the 28th in Houston, Texas at the Astro Arena. We'll open up April on the 4th in Durham, New Hampshire at the Whitmore Center. And April the 11th, the World Arena in Colorado Springs. Tickets for Thunder available for all of those events upcoming. And here comes Dustin Rhodes, and let's relive some of the past moments. This is where Dustin Rhodes was a turncoat. DDTing Terry Funk. And that lit the fire. We even saw Terry Funk break out the chicken against Dustin Rhodes. And there you see what went down this past Monday on Nitro.
Well, it's one thing beating a man with a wounded, mortally wounded chicken, but it's another thing getting hit between the eyes with a cowbell on the end of 20 feet of rawhide rope. It's going to be a lot different. Mr. Kidman, your little girlfriend here better warm up the car because you're not going to be around long.
Well, you make a great point about the bull rope matches. So dangerous by nature, not just for that unforgiving rope that leaves burns and scars all over your body, but also that steel cowbell that you can use as a weapon against your opponent when Dustin Rhodes collides with Terry Funk in 4 days at Uncensored 2000.
When you talk about Terry Funk and the Rhodes family, you're talking about weapons. It could be anything. It could be chairs, tables. Well, like you said, you get hit with that cowbell, pretty much over.
Off the cross body block by Billy Kidman, a two count on Dustin Rhodes. It really is wrestling's version of the Hatfields and the McCoys when the Rhodes and Funks hook it up. And I think really that bad blood now has really carried over to Dustin Rhodes, who is still out to prove to the world that his family is superior to the Funks.
And he remembers every night his dad came home all beat up. He remembers all those nights he was in bed before he had to go to school. This thing has been inside of him for years. Funk's in trouble.
And how about that revealing interview that we just heard with Team Package? They admitted it. The Total Package and Ric Flair just said that Hulk Hogan took the bait, hook, line, and sinker. He fell right into their trap. Hogan tonight issued the challenge. The WCW Executive Committee stepped up to the plate and they made the match. Hogan will face both members of Team Package. It can't be wise for Hulk Hogan this close to Uncensored.
And you know something else, Mike? That very beautiful and dangerous woman, Elizabeth, will be at ringside. I wouldn't be surprised if she's there with a couple ball bats.
Kidman able to avoid the clothesline, springs off the ropes, drives Dustin face first to the mat, and then connects with a standing drop kick.
Whoa!
Hook the legs. Just a two count that time from referee Nick Patrick. And Dustin Rhodes just cut off Billy Kidman with the rake of the eyes.
I mean, years ago, you would mention the name Funk in the dressing room when a Rhodes was there. You could just see their eyes. You could just see the frustration. Same thing that happened with Rhodes. You mentioned Funk. Same thing.
It's all about proving superiority in the wrestling business. There you see Dustin Rhodes. He just used the cowbell.
On Kidman. So what?
Look at that. What do you mean, so what?
It's just Kidman.
What do you mean, he's just Kidman? One of the top rising stars in the world of professional wrestling today.
But notice how Dustin shielded the referee with his body. Notice how he put Kidman in position. Used the bull rope. Just what he wanted to do. And he did it.
A great veteran move on the part of Dustin Rhodes. You're right. Using his body as a shield away from the referee. Using that cowbell attached. Wait, now what? Look at this.
Here comes Booker.
Booker out to the ring. At least he's covering his back.
Nuts up.
Well, Booker, you're a little late.
What do you mean? A little late? At least he came out. I'm still not sure, though, that they can depend on each other in that tag team match against Harlem Heat.
Looks like Booker's washed his hands of the whole situation. He wanted to come out to help him, Mike. He'd have come out 10 minutes ago.
He can't wash his hands. It's his tag team partner this Sunday at Uncensored.
It looks like he's washing his hands to me. Open your eyes, Mike. Take a look. That man's disgusted.
I see a look of disgust on the face of Booker.
Tonight on TNT, hardcore matches that are nastier than ever in WCW Thunder. Brace yourself for Red Hot Super Slam.
Dustin Rhodes this past Monday at Nitro. What happened? Hulk Hogan disrupting the match between you and Curt Hennig.
Hogan, what the hell do you know about the American Dream? You're a vampire. I got a stake with your name on it. You're a disease and I'm the cure. I'm not talking some fancy medicine. I'm talking bloodletting. I'm talking amputation. Cut the bad limb off so the rest can survive. Hogan, I could extract you from your very existence. So what I'm saying right now is, I'm calling you out. And if you got the bag of guts, then you'll step in the ring with the American Nightmare tonight. And we'll see what's going on. Because you will be another one that bites the dust.
Very interesting hearing the comments from the stars of World Championship Wrestling in regards to that situation with Sid Vicious turning his back and then stabbing Hulk Hogan in the back, Brain. Let's check out Hard Knocks' Chris Candido in his his debut in World Championship Wrestling. It was 48 hours ago on Nitro, and he made that debut a winning one by pinning Lash LaRue. Couple of the top cruiserweight stars in World Championship Wrestling, Candido showed everyone with that victory over Lash LaRue, who's among the top cruiserweights, that he belongs in. Oh, that's the artist's locker room, obviously. There you see Paisley and the artist formerly known as Prince Iaukea.
It's awful dark in there.
Where's she heading?
Find the light switch.
Of course, Chavo Guerrero has his sights set on gold, cruiserweight gold. And I think he has some extra incentives since that get-rich-quick scheme went south.
I like this guy, Candido. You gotta respect him. This man has come up the hard way. He didn't get anything handed to him. He earned it.
Yeah, and by the way, has anyone seen Gene Okerlund's Rolexer wallet yet?
I think you'll have to check Chavo's pants. That's probably where it is.
Nice side headlock by Chavo Jr. And, you know, I'm just getting word now from the back. Hulk Hogan has agreed to a match tonight. Yes, tonight against Dustin Rhodes here on Thunder.
We didn't have that down. That's good. I want to see that one.
And we don't have this down either, but Paisley making her way to the ringside area. And looks like Paisley's, I guess she's going to join us here at the broadcast table. How about that for a
stand
bonus?
Stand up when a lady comes.
Well, what a nice treat that we have Paisley here.
Well, you know, the artist in his infinite wisdom sitting out here to scope out the competition.
Yes, I can't blame you there. These are two of the top cruiserweights in the world today in Candido and Chavo Jr.
Well, you know, these two look like worthy opponents, but the artist has not made his final decision as to who's going to get the next shot.
What do you mean? The artist makes his decision. That's not up to him.
So you think.
When you're the champion, Mr. Tanay, and you're the artist, he makes the decision.
That's right.
How about those comments from Chris Candido about valets Monday on Nitro, Paisley?
All right, this man obviously does not know class when he sees it. To call me a trashy valet, please.
But you have to be impressed by Candido's debut Monday.
He was mediocre at best.
Mediocre? Looked great in that win over Lash LaRue. Goes
Lash
again for the
LaRue.
Cover.
The artist beat him easily.
Lash LaRue, he was the number one contender to the Cruiserweight title recently. It was quite an accomplishment for him.
You know, Mike, instead of enjoying the company of this lovely lady here and trying to find some insight as to the nature of the prince, you're arguing with her.
I'm trying to find out what's going on backstage.
You're beating
the artist.
Her.
You know, the artist is a man of very few words. What's the story behind that?
He's far too brilliant for most people to understand, so he doesn't waste his time. I try to translate for him, but most people still don't understand his genius.
It's not easy out there, is it?
It's not.
Boy, are you blinded by the artist. I've never seen such tunnel vision. He can do absolutely no wrong in your eyes, can he?
There is no wrong when it comes to the artist.
Candido.
Told you.
Yeah, continuing the offensive assault. Chavo Jr. trying to fight back.
Candido's in great shape.
I still don't know what you're talking about. The artist making a selection as to who he's going to choose. That's up to the WCW Executive Committee.
Mike, you don't know the artist very well at all.
You don't know what's going on here at WCW. Politics.
A spine buster by Chavo Jr. takes down Candido. Nice reversal by Candido off the ropes. Where are you going now?
Well, nice talking with you. She's a looker.
Chavo goes for the cover. Chavo distracted by Paisley. We've seen that in the past. The roll up by Candido. Gets one, gets two, and kick out by Chavo. Quickly to his feet, Candido able to duck the clothesline. Oh, he just caught him with that power slam.
Candido's good. And he's worked hard to get this good. Like I said before, it wasn't handed to him. I asked him earlier in the back hall, he says, I said, how do you do? He said, I haven't had it.
Whoa, check this out. The artist came down and just knocked Candido off the top. Now the artist off the middle rope. Drops him down to the mat. Chavo looks around, might as well go for the cover, hooks the leg, two in. Oh, now I know how he's gonna choose his opponents. I see what he's up to now. Chris Candido is going to take it out on Chavo.
Why not? Hurt him.
Scoop and a slam. Here comes the master of embellishment. Hard knocks Chris Candido up to the top. Oh, diving headbutt.
He's going to do it again.
Going to try it again, back to the top. Candido. Look at, who is that? Those legs, that has to be Miss Hancock.
Oh. Humming. And they drive me wild.
Drive her wild?
Who?
Who's she talking about?
Us. It must be you and
can't
me.
Can't be Los Fabulosos, can it?
Meaning to free weights.
Big Papa Pump getting pumped up for his match later tonight here on Thunder as we see Team XS, Lane and Rave head to the ring. Listen to this on sale announcement, Brain. This Friday in Chicago, tickets go on sale for the Spring Stampede pay-per-view at the United Center on April the 16th. And this Friday at 3 p.m., you can meet Hulk Hogan and Jimmy Hart at Tower Records in Bloomingdale. We're expecting one of the most well-attended on sales in the history of WCW this Friday in Chicago to see Hulk and Jimmy Hart at Tower Records in Bloomingdale.
I've never heard of Hulk Hogan doing a ticket on sale. It shows you the power that Zane Breslov has.
Also this Friday, tickets on sale in Rochester, New York. Nitro coming to the Blue Cross Arena, and you can meet the Nitro girls at the box office from 10 a.m. to noon, and here comes Miss Hancock.
Wow, what a set of yams.
She's going into the ring. I know she's had problems in the past with Team XS.
Ladies, forget about these two zeros in the ring. I'm about to introduce you to two men who will make you squirm. Two men who will make you squeal. Two men who will make you do things you've never done before. Introducing Latin America's most desirable men, Los Fabulosos.
That is who she was talking about.
You were right. Well, these men south of the border are idols. They have their own day. They have parades. They're worshipped by the people in Mexico more than anyone.
Can you say that with a straight face when you see Los Fabulosos, Silver King, and El Dandy?
El Dandy.
Right. Well, you know, Miss Hancock promised that she was going to take them shopping last Wednesday on Thunder. And I guess clothes do make the man, don't they?
I wouldn't even know where to go buy something like that. But I like it. It's nasty.
I don't think you picked that one up off the rack.
No. Here we go.
Team XS going to jumpstart this matchup. Looks like we have another treat.
Oh, Miss Hancock.
Miss Hancock now at ringside to join us.
How are you, man?
How are you?
Oh, I'm better than nothing.
Miss Hancock, Latin America's most desirable men, El Dandy and Silver King, Los Fabulosos.
These two are going to take America by storm. You just watch.
You know, I have that feeling, Miss Hancock, that you're going to take them to the top. You're going to take them to the championship of the world. They're big, big stars in Mexico right now, but nothing compared to when you're done with them. I have that feeling.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Miss Hancock, I know you wear glasses, but when's the last time you had your eyes examined?
Oh, come on. Forget about Ricky Martin. It's Los Fabulosos.
Forget Ricky Martin?
Ricky who?
Well, you've already forgotten him, haven't you?
That's good.
Well, I'll tell you, Miss Hancock, it sure is a pleasure having you out here. And I wish you could stay around a little longer just to enjoy the evening, like all this action here.
Well, she really dresses things up down here. Brain,
what?
Concentrate on the match going on.
I was signing an autograph.
You were not. You've never signed an autograph out here in your life.
Talking to my friend, Miss Hancock.
El Dandy, quick hook at the leg, goes for the cover, and able to get a two count. The tag team of Los Fabulosos. I know, Miss Hancock, you've had your problems with Team XS, Lane and Rave in the past, yet they just can't seem to get you out of their minds.
Well, they don't know what they're missing, so that's their fault.
Miss Hancock, would you like to sit down and relax a little bit? Would you like to sit on one knee?
No, that's okay. I'm okay.
Both knees?
No, it's okay.
Feel free. Just enjoy yourself.
Okay.
Would you keep your mind on either your monitor or what's going on in the ring?
I don't need a monitor. Not in school. What are you talking about now?
Watch this match.
Oh, double dribble.
Dandy driven face first. Rave with the leg drop to the back of the head.
Ms. Hancock, if you like a cold beverage or something, I'll send Mike out to get something.
No, I'm okay, thanks.
Well, please, messed it up anyway.
Well, please tell us about your long-term plans. You must have something in mind for Los Fabulosos down the line.
Oh, I have plenty of things planned for them.
And you're not going to tell us any more than that, are you?
Nope. You'll just have to watch and see.
Well, that's smart. That's good business. That's using your head. Look at the move.
Sensational moves by Los Fabulosos.
Got him.
Got him.
That's my boy.
Hancock, it was a pleasure having you here.
Well, maybe Close and Miss Hancock are involved in making the man. They're Latin America's most desirable men, you know, at least in her mind.
The Latin American heartthrob. There they are.
And El Dandy and Silver King, after scoring the victory over XS, we're going to celebrate now with Miss Hancock.
Yes.
He needs someone to watch his back, says Screamin' Norman Smiley.
He needs a friend.
As we see the incredible entrance of the man that represents the rock group KISS, it's the Demon. And the way that I've seen the Demon and Screamin' Norman, the Screamin' Demons interact together, cover each other's backs.
Well, they say opposites attract.
My guess is that the Demon is the man that's going to watch the back of Screamin' Norman Smiley.
You can't trust anybody here. I don't know if you can have anybody to watch your back.
Well, this is what went down Monday on Nitro. After the matchup involving Hugh Morris and Screamin' Norman, the Demon came out to the ring. He received a power slam for his trouble, but at least the Demon was there to watch out for Screamin' Norman. And did you see Brian Knopf's locker room? The dog just tore everything up.
You know, it looked to me like the dog was cleaning it up. You know, that's the way Knopf lived. He has been condemned himself four times by the health department.
The laughing man, humorous, who 1 week ago on this program turned in an incredible performance in a matchup against Vampiro. He followed that up this past Monday on Nitro with a victory over Screamin' Norman Smiley. And tonight, he has the Demon. £350 of humorous and among the most agile yet powerful big men in the history of our sport. I've never seen anyone even near his size. Oh, as we see the blood from the mouth of the Demon almost seem to inspire humorous as he goes immediately to the offense. I've never seen anyone who is able to hit that top rope moonsault that's even near his size with such incredible ease. He calls it the no laughing matter.
And Mike, the accuracy. It doesn't matter where that man is in the ring. He can find him. He's like a guided missile. And he never misses. And like you said, that's 350 pounds coming on you like 180 miles an hour off that top rope.
Oh! Out of the corner after the Demon whipped him in. Humorous just exploded with the clothesline and leveled the Demon.
Well, these two are about high impact moves, and you're seeing it right now. These two big men right here.
Oh. Drops down with all of that weight, all of that power across the chest with the elbow. That one wasn't close. You know, from time to time, he does seem to lose it.
He drifts.
Maybe that's really been his biggest problem to date.
It needs to be managed or shock treatment.
One or the other.
But he's a dangerous man. He, like you said, he's an agile, big, dangerous man.
But he does lose that level of concentration from time to time. To the corner, able to duck the clothesline from the Demon, but he didn't duck that, but didn't have much effect, did it?
Well, if the Demon can't knock you over.
Like two big freight trains colliding.
No!
Humorous stops him.
Make a wish.
The enziguri kick delivered to the back of the head by the Demon.
Look at Humorous. He's starting to get up. Hit a shot like that behind the head. Not many people get up.
U.S. title match still to come tonight involving Jeff Jarrett of the NWO to defend against Buff Bagwell plus Hulk Hogan and Dustin Rhodes. To the ropes goes the Demon. Back elbow. That one was on the button. Hook of the leg. Shoulders are down. Gets two from Nick Patrick and only two.
Well, you've got to beat the Humorous up a lot more than that. He's such a big, tough man. I doubt if you can get him, this man to submit. I don't think he will give up.
Could this be it?
Off the top, off the top. I want to see that.
Right here above our broadcast position.
There he goes.
Headed to the top.
Look at the accuracy.
Look out below.
Oh! Three, the money.
350 off the top. And the Demon is not going to kick out or roll a shoulder from that one. Humorous on an incredible roll here in WCW. Another victory chalked up for the 350
better.
Of Big Humorous.
And he's getting better and sharper all the time.
Now that's...
Just stay focused.
Humiliating.
Humiliating. Still to come in this broadcast, the immortal Hulk Hogan to go one-on-one with Dustin Rhodes. That's coming up later here on Thunder. They're coming at him from every direction. And later tonight, he's accepted the challenge. Hulk Hogan will face Dustin Rhodes tonight on Thunder.
Yes.
Well, this is what we've been anticipating. This is what we've been waiting for. Main event time.
The Nightmare is here.
The American Nightmare, and we saw it Sunday night at Uncensored. The pile driver on the cowbell against Terry Funk. And then Monday night, while Dustin Rhodes beat up on Kurt Hennig, Hulk Hogan came to the ring, and the American Nightmare powdered.
Well, did anybody ask for Hogan's help again? No, because he is a show-off. He doesn't want that light to shine on anybody. He doesn't want anybody to become a star. Hogan hasn't... Oh, I want to spit. I can't even talk about this. This stuff can't even be.
Well, how about a little different spit, if you don't mind, for me? Because not only did Hulk Hogan save the world's heavyweight title for Sid Vicious at Uncensored, he's afraid of no challenge, of no one. Because not only did he answer the challenge of Dustin Rhodes for this match here tonight on Thunder, but you heard it just before we went to the commercial break. Hulk Hogan told the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, get Bill Bush. Get Bill Bush from World Championship Wrestling and sign the contract, sign the deal for a match against Sid Vicious. And Brain, I'm wondering, is Sid Vicious still lurking somewhere here in the arena in Orlando, Florida?
Well, you never know what's going through that man's mind. You don't know if that was his gear in the room or not. No one's seen him. No one's had a sighting of him yet. But Hogan, Hogan, you big dummy, you got to get through this big man, this big tough man, this man, Dustin Rhodes, right now. So, Hogan, don't book anything down the road, pal. You don't know if you're going to walk out of here tonight.
There's always something important to consider in any professional sport. And that's the look-ahead factor. Hulk Hogan has his mind on both the American Nightmare, Dustin Rhodes, as well as Sid Vicious, but he has to remain totally focused on Dustin Rhodes now.
Well, you better remain focused on Rhodes.
What a wild match Dustin Rhodes had at Uncensored Sunday against Terry Funk.
Of course.
Just outrageous, that bull rope match between those two.
And you notice something, Mike? Every Wednesday now, it's getting wilder here on Thunder. Every Wednesday, it's going up a notch.
It's like playing a game of can you top this? And the answer is yes. We seem to top it every Wednesday right here on Thunder.
Thunder roulette.
Hogan takes Dustin Rhodes, tosses him back into the ring.
Now, Dustin Rhodes isn't begging off. He's not a coward. He's playing possum.
Think of all the comments that Dustin Rhodes had to say about Hulk Hogan. All the negative comments, all the detrimental words that he had. And that's firing up Hogan.
I'm going to ask you the million-dollar question, Mike. You want to be a millionaire? Answer me this one. This man here, Dustin Rhodes, did he run Terry Funk out of professional wrestling?
I don't know that he's run Terry Funk out of professional wrestling. He beat him Sunday at Uncensored.
That's good enough for me. And I think Hogan is next.
To the corner. The clothesline, the lariat by Hogan in the corner on Dustin. I'm going to shoot him off into the ropes. Hogan telegraphed the back body drop. That may be the opening that Rhodes needs.
And this Rhodes is so agile. He's never in a position where he can make a bad move.
No. Boom. So dangerous out here on the arena floor. And Dustin takes Hogan, sends him face first.
Uh-oh,
into the steel steps. Look out. Not again. Not again.
The right headset.
Okay.
I got static in my. I can't barely hear anything, Mike. We should get combat pay for here.
It's like a war zone down here at the broadcast table every Wednesday on Thunder.
You talking to me?
You can't hear me. Nobody can hear me.
Brain, think about this. I know it's tough to concentrate after what we just went through.
Come on now.
But this is a match that could make the career of Dustin Rhodes. Can you imagine a victory over Hulk Hogan?
Just think of this, Mike. How much is left in this man? How much is there fight left in Hulk Hogan? His whole career, every night, championships all over the world. This man has defended the title against the top athletes in this industry. How much more can he take? How long can he go? Is there anything left in him? I don't know anymore. But it looks like he lives off the people. When they start chanting, his
cover.
Blood starts boiling.
Two count from Nick Patrick. Dustin Rhodes, look at the confidence on his face. Seems so in control after he took Hogan right out here to the broadcast table.
Oh, he's been in control ever since.
First it was head first into the steel steps, then here to the table, and ever since it's been all Dustin Rhodes. He's just neutralizing Hogan at this point.
And you know what I like here? I like strategy. And what Dustin Rhodes is showing me here, he's making no moves. He's not wasting any energy. He's going to make sure he's going to keep Hogan grounded. He's thinking. He's getting his oxygen back.
That's two.
A smart move on Dustin Rhodes' part.
Could this be it?
No. He is still dead alive.
The superhuman effort of Hulk Hogan. How the hell does he do it? Look at those elbows to the midsection.
Like I
told you, Mike. He got him with the clothesline. Cover. One, two.
It's the missed
open. Kick out by Hogan.
But look at Hogan. He's fighting to get back on his feet.
Again, he has to have Sid Vicious at some point in his mind.
I've seen this before.
But now he's got to turn it up and concentrate fully on Dustin Rhodes. Hogan says no way. From one knee, now to his feet.
Stay on him, Dustin. Stay on him. Don't let him breathe. Don't let him see daylight. Stop him.
Dustin Rhodes backpedaling. Hogan, series of right hands right between the eyes. To the ropes. Oh, he ducked a big move. He's already caught him with the clothesline.
It's going to be up. This is going to be it, Mike. He's got him right here.
Look out. He's got the bull rope and that steel bell. Hogan's out. Hogan's knocked out. Oh, and so is Nick Patrick. Dustin Rhodes has lost it.
Good. It's about time somebody loses it around here. Tie him up and brand him. Back.
Dustin Rhodes has snapped. My God, what's happened to him?
And it's about time. It's about time this man here took that cowbell and just drove it right into Hogan's chest.
Dustin Rhodes is just out of control. He's over the edge. The steel cowbell knocking out the referee, knocking out Hulk Hogan. Left Hulk Hogan.
He is man. He's the man that left Hulk Hogan lane.
Dustin Rhodes, wait 1 minute.
I've changed my mind. I'm not going to disqualify you tonight. And you've called this man out. This man is in here. You've got a 10 count to get back in this ring and fight this man, or you're going to get fined $10,000, and I'm going to see about a little suspension time, too.
Yes!
Take this.
Nick Patrick laying down the law.
Now Dustin's got to get back in this ring. He can't let Hogan get to his feet.
He's got to make a decision here.
There isn't a decision to make. He's got to get back in that ring or his 10 G's, and he's done. He has an opportunity now to keep Hogan grounded, and he's got to do that now.
What a great call by the referee, Nick Patrick. The senior WCW official just stepped up to the plate. We're not going to decide it with a disqualification. Hogan shoots Rhodes to the rope. There's the big boot.
And everybody wants to see a conclusion, and I hope this is not.
There's the leg drop. One, two, got him.
The stinks.
He did it.
The stinks.
Hulk Hogan came back from the dead to knock off Dustin Rhodes. The immortal one has done it again. How does he do it, Brain?
Hey,
Hogan.
Wait a minute, whoa.
What's that?
Hogan!
Sid.
Look up in me, son! See, I got your lifeline right here! Watch him! Watch him as he disappears!
God, he's got Jimmy Hart! Oh, no! Oh, God! He just chokeslammed Jimmy Hart through the table!
And Mike Hogan has left the ringside. He's running to the back right now!
What was that? What's that paper that he put on Jimmy Hart's chest? That's been Hulk's lifelong friend, Jimmy Hart.
Oh, God.
Sid Vicious with a vicious chair shot.
Wrong place.
Coming up next, a greatest hit from WCW.
To get that victory back.
Well, of course, it's very important to sustain a victory at WCW. Everybody wants your spot. Everybody wants to stab you in the back. It's so dangerous here. That way you just have to be on top of things.
And Brain, speaking of cruiserweights, how about that debut Monday night for Michael Modest? He stunned everyone by winning a non-title bout over the Artist, and in my mind, the
Well, Michael Mott has certainly moved up the rankings in World Championship Wrestling with that non-title win.
You know, Mike, I don't get impressed easy. I've seen a lot of guys come down the pike. This man impresses me. He's going to be a major player very soon.
Hard Knocks, Chris Candido, Chavo Guerrero Jr., and it's an excellent bridge takeover by Candido for the cover and a two count before Chavo Jr. kicks out.
This Candido's had a rough life. He's earned everything he's got. That's why they call him Hard Knocks. He didn't get anything handed to him. He earned it.
Do you believe all those stories that he talks about? A 10-on-1 handicap match. And oh, Chavo Jr. just shoved him off, and he went right into referee Charles Robinson. And the referee Robinson went through the ropes and all the way onto the floor. I don't know. I think that Hard Knocks Chris Candido oftentimes seems to embellish those stories.
Look at this.
That's the Cruiserweight champ. The artist formerly known as Prince Iaukea in a slugfest with Candido out on the arena floor. Wait a minute. Meanwhile, in the ring, that's Michael Modest. Modest having it out with Chavo Jr. These are four of the top cruiserweights. Oh. The DDT by Chavo Jr. on the float over.
Well, look at Modest. He's still up on his feet. I like this guy.
Modest drops down. Now, this match is Candido versus Chavo Jr. without the referee. Oh. We've lost all control. That's the move that Modest used Monday on Nitro to beat the artist, and now that opens things up for Candido. And Hard Knocks goes off the top rope, connects with the diving headbutt, gets two and three. Got the three count.
Well, you tell me what's going on here. Is it four? Is it tag match? Is it a battle royal? You got me.
And the artist immediately in the ring. That evens the score, I guess, between Candido and Chavo Jr. Interference for both victories. And now look at Modest go to work on the artist. To the ropes and elevates him with the back body drop. It just turned into a four-way slugfest.
There goes Candido.
Back body drop by Chavo Jr. sends Candido as well out to the floor. This match is over. I don't think anybody told Chavo. Oh, is that incredible? Springing off the top, he hit the planche, the cross body block on the arena floor. Look at the champ.
He's going after the prince.
And the artist and Paisley bail out. And now it's Michael Modest and Candido fighting up the aisle. What a wild way to kick off Thunder. And this portion of Thunder, as we take another look at this slow-mo here, Brain. Look at Modest. What an impressive move.
You know, the funny thing is Modest isn't even involved in the match. This man is going to be a big, big star, I'm telling you. And Candido takes advantage of the situation, goes up on top with that flying headbutt right between the eyes of Guerrero, goes into the cover, and he gets the one, and the two, and the three. Your winner, Hard Knocks. Candido, look at that.
That's post-match. Chavo Jr. airborne and connecting on both Candido and Modest. A quick programming reminder. Next week, Monday's Nitro, Wednesday's Thunder will be recap shows tracing the history of Nitro from its inception to the present. And in addition to the recap, we will have any updates, any late-breaking news on the Eric Bischoff story. You do not want to miss Nitro or Thunder next
and
week.
He is the stump.
And you know, looking back, you're going to see a lot of great action. And you might see some things you didn't remember, or you forgot, or you might see some things happen that none of us know about. New stuff.
You make a great point about that, Brain. You know, we just heard from Brian Knobbs his feelings about Bischoff and Russo. Check this out. At the conclusion of this matchup involving Buff Bagwell and La Parka, we will hear what the Nature Boy Ric Flair has to say about Bischoff and Russo.
The mother being X-rated.
The April pay-per-view tradition for World Championship Wrestling is Spring Stampede. It's April the 16th in Chicago, Illinois at the United Center. Tickets went on sale last Friday. Over 5,000 tickets were sold on opening day. You don't want to miss out on Spring Stampede. April 16th, that's just 6 days after the return of Bischoff and Russo to WCW. What an unpredictable pay-per-view that Spring Stampede could be.
And it will be their first pay-per-view working together. So who knows what we're going to see in Chicago?
Oh, it's going to be history-making. You don't want to miss it.
And Tom may be on fire again.
We told you about the upcoming Nitros. Thunders as well. April the 11th, the day after the return of Bischoff and Russo. Thunder in Colorado Springs, Colorado at the World Arena. La Parca with a microphone again?
What's up? Skull Captain in the his house. You see the chat, you know the deal. You don't need the 411 when you got the 1414. One for me and one for my homies.
It's not
I ain't done talking yet.
I told you it wasn't La Parca.
Hey, pretty boy. That's right. I'm talking to you, Lumpy. You want to throw down with the chairman?
Look at that.
I'm going to knock that stupid George Clooney haircut right off the top of your greasy head, and then I'm going to kick your jacked up ass.
You know, this guy's getting La Parca into trouble at every turn.
So what?
He's not really doing this. He's sorry about it. All it does is get under the skin of La Parca's opponents.
You know, I think La Parca is trying to set Buff up. I think this man can throw his voice. I think he's just that good. He's a ventriloquist. You know what a Mexican ventriloquist is called in Mexico?
No, what?
I don't know. I never remember.
Not much of a payoff there.
Not much of a payoff in Mexico anyplace.
I've heard that.
I've been a lot of places where they get a lot of good payoffs.
It looks like they've worked out their differences. Oh! You know what? You might be right.
I told you. I told you. And I'm not the kind of a guy to say I told you so, but if I was the kind of guy to say I told you so, I'd tell you right now I told you so. And I'm not that kind of a guy to say I told you so. You want to say it, Mike? You go say it, but I'm not going to say it.
All I'm going to say is for once, you might be right. La Parca into the corner. Oh, Bagwell able to move out of the way. Oh! La Parca just elevated Bagwell. He went face first into the top turnbuckle. Oh, but he ran right into the boot. Oh! Bagwell sprinting out of the corner, and he was just leveled with that clothesline. You always have to think about the neck injury that Buff Bagwell suffered over a year ago, and when you see him go down like that with that kind of an impact, still able to get to his feet. The back body drop. And that clothesline was on target.
Well, Bagwell looks better than he ever has, in my opinion.
Boot to the midsection, springs off the ropes. Spinning neck breaker by Buff. Yeah, he's the stuff.
I like that outfit on La Parca.
Remember, yet to come this evening on Thunder. Oh, that was a low blow. You'll see the Wall versus Vampiro. One thrives on pain, one thrives on dishing out pain and punishment. Who takes the next step? The future of World Championship Wrestling. Will it be the Wall to take that big step? Or will it be the man that's been on an incredible roll as of late? Speaking about Vampiro.
Well, they're both going to be happy because Vampiro's going to get the tail kicking of his life and the Wall's going to do it to him. So they're both going to enjoy themselves.
Oh. Open hand slap to the chest of Bagwell. To the ropes. Ducks the clothesline. Caught him with the knee to the midsection. Double arm DDT, spiked him, dropped him on his head.
You know, now that Bischoff is back, and now that Russo's back, think of this, the Wall may try to impress them. You know what he might do? He may take his opponent tonight, Vampiro, and take him up in the balcony and drive him.
Don't even say that.
That could happen,
Rule
Mike.
Up two, and La Parca kicks out. Don't even, after what we saw, to Bam Bam Bigelow, to Crowbar, to David Flair as La Parca connects with the Enziguri. The cover, hook of the leg, gets two in, Bagwell kicks out. Don't even mention that.
Think about it though, what if he takes that freak up in the rafters? Takes him up on the roof, he could do it. He's big enough, tough enough.
And if he does, then the Wall's the one that takes the next step. Look at that, double spring. Oh. Gets one, got two in, Bagwell, he was able to kick out.
I don't know how he did.
What velocity. La Parca came springing off the top rope, crashing down onto Bagwell.
It's like he speared him. He's going to try it again.
Bagwell, slow to recover. Twisting moonsault that time, nobody home. Bagwell, look at him trying to clear the cobwebs.
I was just going to say that. We think alike, Mike. You're gonna make it.
Block and a right hand. Thanks for the vote of confidence. Just what I need at this point. Gonna try and send him across. Now the reversal by La Parca. Back elbow turned him inside out.
That's the stuff, all right.
Could it be blockbuster time? The fans think so. They're on their feet in Houston. Buff just measuring him. Oh. There's the Buff blockbuster out of the corner. Two and three.
So much for the world's biggest bumblebee.
Buff Daddy, celebration time. Very competitive matchup against La Parca. To save his hide because the Mamalukes were right in his face.
Well, until you see the contract with their John Henry's on it, you don't really know. But would you really call Disco a liar?
You ever looked up the word liar in the dictionary?
Yes.
Yeah, there's two pictures. One of them, well, looks a lot like you, as a matter of fact. And the other one is the Disco Inferno.
I'll take that as a personal insult. I am not a liar.
They lock it up. Big Vito, big Stevie Ray, and Stevie Ray with the size and strength advantage just pulls Big Vito into the corner. Big Vito comes out, series of knees to the midsection and a clubbing blow to the back. Which rare that you see Big Vito dominated like this by anyone. Look at the size of Harlem Heat 2000 with Big T on the ring apron at 350 pounds. Stevie Ray in the ring at 300 pounds. And that big cash at ringside with Jay Biggs, he goes 400 pounds. That's over 1,000 pounds of Harlem Heat. And Big Vito with a comeback. Scoop and a slam.
A lot of heat.
Double chop. as Stevie Ray reeling and turns things over to Johnny the Bull. Nice double teamwork, putting the boots to Stevie Ray. Mamelukes have one thing in mind only, that's regaining the gold. The World Tag Team title belts currently residing with the New World Order with the Harris Brothers. Mamelukes want to get that gold back. Springing off the top. And Stevie Ray just fly swatted him away.
What a move.
Springboard attempt by Johnny the Bull did not connect, but that sidekick from Stevie Ray certainly did connect, and he turns things over.
See, Disco should be out here. Disco should be out here with the team.
Think he's in any shape to come out here, the Disco Inferno, after that big punch from Tank Abbott?
Well, he's out, but he's not here. Probably still out. Big T is a big, big man. Mean character.
Slow, methodical, yet oh so effective. Drives him down to the mat. There's Big T with the spine buster.
Did he nail him? Paisans had their opportunity. When they had Stevie Ray down, they should have rolled him over to the corner, kept him in the corner. They allowed him to make that tag to Big T, and it don't look good.
Well, if anybody knows about tag team strategy, it has to be you, Bobby the Brain. And in all the years that you managed so many of the great tag teams, and you're right, they did not cut off the ring. They did not bring Stevie Ray to their side of the ring, to their corner, where they could use double-team tactics.
Well, it's a different style now than when I managed. And it's going to be a different style of wrestling April 10th, believe me. And I'll tell you, it's going to be a different style tonight when you see the wall and that oddball, that freak, Vampiro.
Vampiro, who thrives on pain, the wall, who loves to dish it out. Many people calling the wall and Vampiro the future of World Championship Wrestling. Who takes the big step tonight? Oh, from behind, Stevie Ray just clocked Big Vito. Referee Nick Patrick momentarily here has lost control. Harlem Heat 2000 with the double team on Johnny the Bull. Now they send him out to the arena floor.
Harlem Heat is really manhandling the Paisans. Usually they're in control. They're doing all that jaw and all that talk. Look at this.
400 pounds of cash with a bell hole. Oh. Then drives Johnny the Bull back first.
Somebody call the meat wagon.
Directly into that steel ring post. What's Jay Biggs doing over there?
What size do you think his arms are, 50? Look at the size of the arms and the chest and the back on that man.
He's huge.
You could run movies on his back in an outdoor theater.
Now that's big.
A twin screen.
A multi-cinema. In the ring, Big Vito, Big T, and Harlem Heat just too strong with the double team, and now look at this, just cash comes right into the ring. Nick Patrick says, enough is enough, and calls for the bell. Jay Biggs looking on.
Jay did Biggs he slapjack him, Mike?
If he did, it was out of my view.
Out of mine, too. I hear the people behind me yelling, but I just can only call what I see in my monitor with my horizontal visual.
Nick Patrick is throwing this out, a disqualification.
What happened, Nick? What happened?
On Thunder, a bout that we've been anticipating, Brain, a lot of us for about several months. The future of World Championship Wrestling. Who will take WCW into the year 2000 and beyond? Will it be this man, Vampiro, who certainly Monday on Nitro seem to be firmly aligned with Hulk Hogan in a matchup that Hogan had, that $500,000 bounty against the wall. Vampiro was there to back up Hogan at every turn.
Well, you tell Vampiro when you see him today. And a lot of people have been in the corner for Hogan. A lot of people have been there for Hogan. But Hogan has done one thing. He has stabbed them all in the back.
And here comes the monster. The man who has been taking apart, dismantling WCW piece by piece. The wall hits the ring. He tossed a steel chair in, and Vampiro immediately goes to the offense with right hand. Oh, look at the velocity that he sent him in. And then he caught him. Turnaround spin kick by Vampiro to the chest. Oh, chair to the face. And the wall going to try and regroup out to the floor. Vampiro turns up the heat. Oh, jumping off the top and connecting with the wall.
I'll tell you, Vampiro's made it. He's here to stay in WCW. No question about that. He'll take it right to you all night long. And the more you pound on him, the more he likes it.
Remember, you talked earlier about that sprained ankle. Some even say it's a broken ankle that Vampiro has. It's not going to keep him from battling with the wall, because as we all know, the freak loves pain. Corner to corner, and he just walked right into the big boot.
And the wall loves dishing it out.
Turned him inside out, did the wall.
Give him a double order.
Caught him with the lariat, and then puts the boot to the head of Vampiro. This big monster, 6'5", 300. I thought he was gonna power bomb him, and instead he just propelled him overhead, stomach first across that top steel cable.
Well, when you got that kind of power and that kind of strength, you can take a human being just about anywhere you want to.
We're talking about the future of World Championship Wrestling. Eric Bischoff, Vince Russo, taking over on April the 10th. You know, the consensus opinion has been that Eric Bischoff built Nitro on the established stars. Vince Russo looking to build on, well, maybe people looking for a chance. The future talent, it's a different approach between the two. Both of these men are the future, however, and Vampiro digs down deep, and he just lifted the huge wall overhead with the back suplex.
Well, like you said, Mike, it's a different look. And believe me, April 10th starts a different look here at WCW. In 35 years, I've been in this industry, I've seen a lot of changes, but the rumble that's going around right now, this is gonna be huge. This is gonna be the biggest thing ever for our industry.
What a punch by the wall, using the steel chair as well, and he just knocked out Vampiro. Vampiro slowly gets, wait a minute, oh no.
A table, you know what that means.
You talked about it. You talked about the bodies that the wall has left. Remember when that on Monday on Nitro, when the table was set up, Vampiro came to the ring. Vampiro and Hogan both sent the wall crashing through the table, but it had no effect at all. The steel chair to the head from Vampiro, and down goes the wall again through the table. Referee Mickey J calls for the bell. I think he's thrown this match out.
I'm surprised Vampiro even got up.
I'm surprised the wall. He's still conscious.
He's still alive.
He's choking still the life out of Mickey J.
It's not over yet. He's
just
getting to his feet.
Mickey J away.
Mikey's getting to his feet.
Good God.
And he's mad.
He got up again.
He's mad as hell, Mike.
The wall. He's stalking Vampiro. Vampiro can't believe it.
He's still staying with him.
It's a slugfest.
He could have
retreated. Standing toe to toe. The wall and Vampiro, both with right hands. Vampiro down to a knee. He keeps on fighting.
Here come the troops.
Finally, security comes in. And the wall's just, he's cleaning security out of the ring.
And so is Vampiro. He's not, they just want to get at each other. Let him go. Let him go. This
Turn
is
them loose.
Take
Turn
the
these guys
down.
Loose. Now referees out as well.
Look at Mike, they're not done with each other yet. They want more of each other.
Like two big freight trains. What a battle this has been
and
between the wall and Vampiro.
And Vampiro's still standing.
Nothing's been settled.